Hey guys, welcome back. Dreamweaver23 here, and playing some more towns. I'm doing the commentary live this time instead of doing a overdub. So, yeah. Fun stuff. I was trying to do the overdub because I wanted to get rid of a lot of the little feedback. I know you guys probably can barely hear it, but there's just audio. It's like, shh. And it's really annoying to me. I don't get the audio whenever I'm doing any of my recording for parodies or anything like that. Only when I'm recording games. I think it's just because there's no... the software tries to pick up every bit of sound. I'm not sure. I'm not a doctor, if you will. Let us open up our Diet Mountain Dew. Ah, that's a good sound right there. And get started in here. So welcome back, guys. Dreamweaver23 here with another Let's Play episode of Towns. I already said that. Cool. If not, there it is. So we started off on this new town and everything like that for a series, which the last time that I've done towns, and I know I've talked about this before, but the last time I did towns was just tutorials, and I've started playing a bit more of it on the stream. I love this game. This is probably one of my favorites as of recent. Turn T off. And it's a fun game. I can't explain it. But we are going to be first unpausing the game. And we're going to be basically adding more stuff here. I am missing a tree spot. Plant a single tree. We have plenty of wood in here. So we're going to add on with our bakery. We're going to add a kitchen. We have this to where they can be connected right there. So we're going to speed up time. I do spend a lot of time, especially when you're first starting out, I spend a lot of time with just it on full speed. Makes it go so much quicker and smoother. Gotta love the sound of their eating. It's like the loudest sound ever. But, I mean, and if I go through and go to options here, it's only on... Oh, it's on 30% now. Put it on 20%. It was on... 20% before. And the reason why we're building a kitchen right here is because beside the bakery, so we'll have bakery, kitchen, and these will be the same area, and then this area over here will just be nothing but actually cancel order right there. Alright, and second layer. So the reason why I'm leaving that door open and this door open is for doorways, so they can get into the front, and then also right here. So this will be over here. This area right here will be just nothing but cows. It'll be a cow farm, and they'll harvest. This is where they'll get to be able to butcher cows. So I know that we haven't gotten anything. We haven't got any, you know, rooms or anything like that built so that the new citizens can come into town. But you don't want to build up too fast, and that's the biggest thing that I've learned, is because you can get good and then everything fall to shit, basically. And we are going to end up moving this prepared food barrels. Prepared food barrels. And I do realize that it's not as big as the other one over there. But, give me time. So we'll have him take all this out of here. And then destroy prepared food barrel. And this one we'll have it to where it enables all. So we'll start moving all that over into it. Work faster. Oh, look, here's one. Enable all. Manage prepared food label. Barrel, disable all. So having it done that way makes it to where it's a bit more fluid for them to do stuff, I guess. Ooh, crap. Beck. We're gonna pause that. Before they die. No, don't die. Alright, now they can get up and down, back and forth. Let's destroy that scaffolding and that scaffolding. Alright, next round up top. They always seem to have problems with that. Taking a break? What the hell's going on? Alright. While they're doing that, we are going to go here for the kitchen and add... See, the kitchen table is... We need a butcher's table right here up the front. Now this one, we are probably going to go through the, just making it a flat roof. Be a bit easier. Outside here, we're going to put our scaffolding back. To me, it's just weird that they can do things out of order like that. Thank you. Doing it this way, over the time that I've been playing that, I've found that if you do it one row at a time, they can't mess it up too bad. The best way that can sound. Like, you know, they do it really smart with the little AI system and everything with the system, but sometimes it doesn't seem to work in anybody's favor, the way they lay stuff out. And if you put up too many things at once for them to do, they will screw it up. Bottom line. So by doing it one layer at a time, like one row at a time, it might take a little bit longer. But if you have your, you know, base kind of set up, you know, where they have food, they have a consistent supply of food, you have everything to where everybody has a job. Well, not everybody, but you have your job settled. You have people that are growing, you have people that are making food, you have haulers that are hauling the food into their area, so you're not just having a ton of stuff laying on the ground, because that always just annoys the shit out of me. Done. Which I think that this might make it to where the roof looks a little weird, having it to where you're, you know, how we'll have this next little row set up. Come on, guys, finish the roof. Making me look like a damn fool. See how this is going to turn out. I wish you could turn the camera. Yeah, that's what I figured. It kind of, it's not terrible, actually. It just connects them like that. All right, so now they have a little walkway through their area. Destroy the scaffolding. Destroy scaffolding. Destroy scaffolding. Okay, so we have the butcher's tables in here. We need to add... We need iron for a stove. But we can... put kitchen tables in. Actually... cancel that. Nope. Kitchen table. And we'll put one more right here. Now we will need iron for the stove, but that's copper. I thought that was an iron spot. Sometimes you can find the iron just right on the surface. Doesn't look like we have any right here. Gravel. So we will have to dig down for that. But with us having copper so close to the surface right here, that means we might be in a good ore area. Give me 1 second, guys. Alright, and I am back. So a lot of people won't give this game a second look because of how it looks. I mean, it doesn't look the greatest. A lot of people always do the comparison, oh, it's like Minecraft and Terraria mixed into a little... No, no. It's its own game. I like it. And if you do give it a chance, I think that you also will like it. It's a really fun game. Alright, let's finish up. This fencing. No, not log wall. Farm fence. All That lines up. By using the shovel, it digs down, like you. So you're seeing what's down below where you need, where you're wanting them to mine or whatever. And it allows you to kind of get full areas done. Stone out of that too, which is good because we need that. So as you can see, I mean, we're keeping our bread filled mostly. We actually need to check to see why we're not getting more done. Food, we have 9 bread and 11 apples. That's actually pretty good. We're gonna make some more raw materials, barrels. So we got 5 over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Depends on where they start out on it, I guess. Now, you can't set up a burner and actually have them destroy the mud, but you do want to keep a certain amount. And the reason is because you want to be able to make the potted plants and the flowers and stuff like that, because that really raises happiness, and happiness is how you get more citizens. You have to have the places for them to sleep and the happiness. I think it's like they have to have a minimum happiness of 20 or something like that. Alright, so we are going to go into here, and I went to the options before I set up this game and turned off. You can actually turn on a thing to where whenever they create a barrel, a raw material barrel or whatever kind of barrel, that it automatically disables anything in there, so that you have to enable, because if not, they just start loading everything in there and then they have to take everything back out. It's kind of a pain in the butt. So this side is going to be nothing but stone. Which just I guess we actually should put it to where it's stone and iron and copper. And I mean, it should be said too that this is really just kind of starting off. I mean, this is what you're going to be building whenever you first start off. This game is not something that you can play and master in a short amount of time. I have another one that I do on the stream, and we're building a castle, like huge stuff out there. And there's literally, you know, probably about 30, 40 hours into it, and it's still nowhere near completion. And that's going pretty much at full speed the whole time, which I'm doing now. Destroy these really quick. One, because I really don't need them right now, but two, we'll find more. You'll always find more. We actually will be making this one out of stone. Give it a nice look. Alright, everybody has gear. Good. Gotta make sure your people are protected. Where it's open back there so we can place I actually kind of want to have it to where the like that's where they will start going underground, so whenever we place down the farms and stuff like that, we won't be able to put them where there's stone. Kill rooster. Just because. Going to add right here, we have our utilities. We're going to be adding a burner. We'll add this right, just like right in front of this building right here. Are we out of stone? Yes, we are. Wow, okay. Alright, now with the burners, you can actually go into this right here on the very first level, burner, and you can say, okay, I only want to have, like, no more than 10 mud. And they'll start going and bringing the mud over and burning it. It just destroys it, so you don't have to go through and right-click everything. Makes it much easier on your life. We will still go through and destroy mud, though. So that we can create our line how we want it. See, I don't know. I mean, there's so much to do in this game. And I know I don't talk a lot. It's because I'm thinking about what to do next and how I'm going to design stuff out. Now, this is just surface level. If you haven't ever seen this game before, this is just surface level. You know, you have all the undergrounds to go, and you have heroes to get in. You have citizens that, you know, you need to build up. And it's really cool. It's awesome. Awesome game. So, but that is going to be this episode wrapping up. Make sure you guys join me next time. And until then, I am DreamRaver23 reminding all of you to game happy. And I'll see you all later. Bye, guys.